here's the thing. The value of Indonesians, if I may just put it in one sentence, is kebersamaan, togetherness. You want to share your happiness. Your daughter is getting married. You would want anyone. Hang on for a second. You would want anyone you have met in your life, who she has met in her life.
But you haven't seen for 20 years.
To be sharing. And that's part of being togetherness, because it has happened in cases of my friends, you know, that someone didn't get invited. You know, someone from the junior high school
didn't
get invited. But the rest of her friends got invited, and it became sort of like a problem. Like, oh my God, everyone in the class got invited. I didn't get the invite.
You're inviting your junior high classmates to your wedding?
In Indonesia, even my elementary school.
Well, I don't remember. Thank you. You will see that on my wedding.
Yeah. But you know, I think in Indonesia there is this emphasis on communal sort of communal relations.
Yes.
And you need to put, you know, it's a social fabrics of you know, families and relatives.
We're not
and
disputing weddings. We're just talking about the extravagant, the overdoing it, the 10,000 people weddings. And you've been to those where you're squeezed in like sardines in the can.
I've not only been to those.
You've held it.
She had one. She had one.
I had, no, not once. I had three of those.
Well,
you know. Well, not three weddings, not three marriages, but you know.
You had to hold it over 3 days, kind of like in Bollywood
and
almost. You know, Andy Bayuni, a good friend from the Jakarta Post, wrote about this in the Jakarta Post the past week, and he stated very well, you know, particularly it's government officials who throw these massive parties. Well, okay, but I'm saying because it's a work thing. You know, you got to hire your subordinates.
You got to hire your boss,
the president, if he can come. Everybody hopes he come.
Right.
But what's maddening about to me about all this is when you go to those kind of weddings, they're spending like hundreds of thousands of dollars. You don't even get a seat. I don't understand. I mean, where I'm raised and come from, everyone gets a seat at a table and you get to eat properly instead of you seeing an 82-year-old lady trying to cut her meat with one hand and trying to, you know, balance it. It doesn't work.
Yes.
There's no seats in these weddings.
Yes.
They're standing.
Yes, but then you look at it from that point of view.
You guys don't mind it? Do you mind?
No. You get invited. You get to share that day. At the price of standing, yes, because that's how Indonesians celebrate the weddings.
And maybe they want people to leave. I mean, that's what, you
know
what I mean?
I don't know about
if
that.
You seat, you stay there all night.
But you know what?
We see more and more a trend of people, you know, like actually downsizing the weddings.
On their own will.
On their own will. Not because of the government's regulations.
Yeah.